Okay, so today we will start with the last chapter of class 10, okay, which is periodic table classification. Why last chapter? That is because this chapter is very, very important from class 11 point of view if you wish to take sciences, and it is an easier chapter than the previous chapter, which is carbon and its compounds. Okay. So when we are doing classification, obviously classification over here we are going to do of elements. Okay? So before going on to the main chapter, let's just take a recap that what do we understand by elements. Right? Elements, they are pure substances, this we know. Pure substances. And they have one kind of atoms, okay? Pure substances having one kind of atoms, that are elements. Now initially, if we're talking about history of elements, there were many less elements which were known to human beings or to man, which were approximately 32 elements which were known initially. Right. This also I am talking of much later. Slowly and gradually more and more elements they were being discovered. Initially just a handful of elements the people used to know about. And about those handful of elements, it was very easy to know their properties, to memorize their names and also memorize their properties at the same time. Slowly and gradually the number kept increasing. Okay. So now when the number kept increasing, it is very difficult to know the names and the properties of each of the members. Like if you are sitting in a class, if you are a group of 10 students in a class, it's very easy for the teacher to memorize everybody's characteristics. So if we're talking of one child, we're saying that child has long hair or she's fair or this and that, right? But as the number keeps growing and we have a class of 100 students, then it is seen that in government schools specifically, because there are large number of students in one class, so over there, the teachers know their students only by row numbers. They don't even know their names. So the same thing was happening over here. As and when more and more elements they were being discovered, it became very difficult to keep a track of all their properties. Okay. So 32 say, abhi if we're talking of as of today, the elements, total number of elements, they are 118. Okay, the 118th element also that was discovered in December 2016, which was authenticated by the IUPAC. Okay, which is IUPAC is one of the, you can say, a committee of sciences which approves the names of the elements and the elements. Okay, so when the first classification of elements which was given in history, majorly they were classifying elements into two, one which were metals and the other which were non-metals, right? So we had only two this thing, and the classification that was given by the father of chemistry, who was Lavoisier, Antony Lavoisier, he is known as the father of chemistry. He gave the first classification as metals and non-metals. The properties of distinction between the metals and non-metals, they are that metals, he clubbed all those elements under metals which were lustrous, okay, which were good conductors, and you know the properties already, which were malleable, which were ductile. Malleable means they can be drawn into sheets, and ductile, which means they can be drawn into wires. Okay. So all those which showed these characteristics, Lavoisier, he put them under metals. Like for example, initially the metals which were known, they were the coinage metals. The currency was made from copper, gold and silver. So they are known as the coinage metals. So all those metals, they showed the same kind of properties. Therefore, he said, okay, these are elements which are metals. And the non-metals were those which had opposite properties of opposite properties than metals, like they were non-lustrous, okay, they were bad conductors, right? Then they were not malleable, they were not ductile. So all these, they were properties of non-metals. But then there were certain elements which did not fit into these properties. Neither were they metals, nor the, they were showing the properties of non-metals. So the second scientist who described the second classification that was given by a scientist whose name was Daubigny, right? So the classification which is given by Daubigny, that is known as Daubigny's triads. Okay, why triads? Because he grouped the elements. He grouped the elements into triads or into groups of three. Three elements together. Groups of three elements together. Right? Now, how did he arrange these elements? He arranged the elements in such a manner such that the atomic mass of the central element, it was an average of the first and the third. Okay? Like for example, we are saying that the atomic mass of lithium, that is 7, the atomic mass of potassium is 39. So according to Daubigny, the expected atomic mass of sodium should be 39 plus 7 divided by 2, okay, which came to 23. And this was absolutely correct when otherwise calculated. The atomic mass of sodium, that was 23. Okay. Another one, there were at least 4 or 5 triads which we had done, but as it is now, you should only know this one, which is in your syllabus, lithium, sodium and potassium. Otherwise, there was another one which was calcium, strontium and barium. Right? Now, the atomic mass of calcium, that is 40. To be more precise, it is 40.1. The atomic mass of barium is 157.3. Okay? So, when we calculating the atomic mass of strontium, it should be 40 plus 137.3 divided by 2. Okay? So, this number that was coming to 88.7, right? And the actual mass of strontium, that was 87.6. So that was quite close. So this Daubigny's, this triad was also successful. Then there was another one, which is chlorine, bromine and iodine. The atomic mass of chlorine, that is 35.5, okay? And the atomic mass of iodine is 126.9. So if you're calculating the average of bromine, for the mass of bromine, that should be 35.5 plus 126.9 divided by 2. Okay? So this number, that was coming to 79.9. Sorry, it was coming to 81.2. So this was coming to 81.2. And the atomic mass of bromine, that is 80. So that was also very close. But as and when more elements they were discovered, they failed to show this property which was given by Daubigny's triad. So the need was felt to give us another arrangement, right, of elements. So this arrangement was initiated by the next scientist whose name was Newland. So the next scientist, the third classification that was given by Newland, and his law is known as Newland's law of octaves. Okay, octaves means 8. According to this law, every eighth element showed similarities to the first element. Okay? So every eighth element showed similarities in properties the first end. Just like sound of music, octaves generally use the notes of music, right? We have sa, re, ga, ma, pa, tha, ni, and sa. Then sa and the eighth one and the first one both are sa. In similarly, if you're doing it in English, the notes of music, then it is do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. So the first one and the eighth one, it has the same note. So similarly, over here also, octaves just means this only, that the first element and the eighth element, they had similar properties. So according to him, he designed or he arranged the elements in such manner. Like we have the first one as lithium. You know all the symbols, na? So this is lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. We have another category of elements which are known as noble gases, which were not discovered during the time of Yunnan. These were discovered later. Okay. So the next member came under the first member because the first and the eighth member, they had similar properties. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and then the eighth one. Okay. Then usi tarah se we go further. We have magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine. Okay. And after that, again we come to the next one, which is potassium. So potassium is again placed under sodium because all these three, they had the same properties. Then the next member, that was calcium. So Yunnan's law of octaves was only given till calcium, and after that he failed to place the elements in their respective positions. So this was Yunnan's this thing. If you want to write down the limitations of Yunnan's law of octaves, that you can write limitations of Yunnan's law of octaves. Number one, the law of octaves was found applicable only up to calcium. Applicable only up to calcium. Number two, position of hydrogen along with fluorine and chlorine. Along with fluorine and chlorine was not justified. Okay. So basically, agar hum log isko dekhe, the first arrangement that was given was that he started the elements from fluorine and chlorine. We have placed first over here, but according to him, he started his classification from here. Like we place fluorine and we place chlorine over here according to his classification. Okay? And when we are talking of hydrogen, the placement of hydrogen, that was not proper. So these were the drawbacks of Yunnan's law of octaves. After the Yunnan's law of octaves, many more elements they were discovered. So a bigger arrangement of elements that had to be decided on to. So Locher-Meier gave his next arrangement. Okay. The next arrangement that was given by Locher-Meier, and it is known as Locher-Meier's arrangement of elements. Locher-Meier's arrangement of elements, right? Now in this case, there was one statement which was given by Locher-Meier. You can write down. According to Locher-Meier, the atomic volume of an element is the volume occupied by one mole of the element in its solid state. Right? So in other words, we can can say that Lothar Mayer, he classified the elements on the basis of atomic volumes. Okay. So this was the base of Lothar Mayer's arrangement. The Lothar Mayer's arrangement, like for example, if we have three elements, one is lithium, the other one is sodium, and the next one that is potassium. All these elements, they were placed together, right? So we have just seen in the Newland's law of octave also that lithium, sodium, and potassium, they were placed one after the other because they had similar properties. Okay, therefore, because of the same properties, they should be given such spaces or they should be given such positions that if we know the property of one, the rest of the properties can be manipulated. Okay? So this was the basic idea of Lothar Mayer's arrangement. Now, what was this? Basically, now we have many elements together. So there was a lot of chaos. The elements, they could not be studied properly because there were so many elements to remember and there were so many properties of elements to be remembered. There was no, you can say, segregation which could be done for the elements. So there was a lot of chaos. This periodic table, which was suggested by Lothar Mayer, was the first initiative to give us certain idea such that we could make order out of chaos. Okay, so this was the first initiative which was taken. Now in this, because Lothar Mayer's arrangement was not put on paper, he just suggested something, okay, we can do like this, or we can make these elements together, we can segregate these elements. So these were such statements which was given by Lothar Mayer, but he could not prepare his paper and he was unable to present his paper. So the idea, his idea was used further by Mendeleev, right? So Mendeleev was the scientist who gave us the first periodic law. Okay, so what is this periodic law? According to Mendeleev, the properties of elements are a periodic function of their atomic weights. So they are a periodic function of their atomic weights, which means that he arranged the elements in order of increasing atomic weights. Right? Now when Mendeleev started his work, only 63 elements were known. Right? Slowly and gradually more and more elements kept coming in. So mainly what he said, he classified or he had the base of those elements which easily formed compounds with oxygen and hydrogen. So all those which formed compounds with oxygen and hydrogen, they were said to be very reactive elements. Right? So he arranged all these elements together. All those which were forming compounds with oxygen and hydrogen, he said that they should be kept together because of their similar reactivities. Okay? So this was the basic idea of the Mendeleev's periodic table. So in the classification of Mendeleev's periodic table, we have to keep in mind two things, that his classification was based on the fact that the elements were arranged in order of increasing atomic masses. Okay. And number two, that he grouped the elements with similar properties together. So second base was that he grouped the elements with similar properties of, you can say, the periodic table, and the Mendeleev's periodic table in detail we will study.